Good morning, children. I hope you all are safe and healthy at home. So, children, today I am going to explain chapter 5 named Hector Hummingbird from your literature book. So, first of all, we are going to learn about the characters. We will come to know about the characters of this chapter. So, children, here we have some characters. So, see here, first one is Hummingbird. It is a bird. Okay, second character which we have, that is Oliver Owl. This is the second character. Now third character is King and his family. Okay, King, Queen and Princess. It is his family. Okay, so children, now I'm going to explain you chapter. So everyone take out your book and just keep your finger where I'm going to read. Something big was happening in the forest. Hector Hummingbird could feel the excitement. So, something big is going to happen in the forest, and this Hector Hummingbird could feel it. He could feel that something is going to happen in the forest. He flitted over to where Oliver Owl was sleeping on a branch. So, he moved lightly on a branch where Oliver Owl was sleeping. Now, who is waking me up? Asked Oliver Owl grumpily. Meaning of grumpily is in an anger manner. So, Oliver Owl, he said in anger that, who is trying to waking me up? Something is happening. I can feel it, said Hector. So, Hector Hummingbird said, I can feel that something is going to happen in the forest. Yes, yes. And you need me to tell you what it is, growled Oliver. His huge eyes wide open now. Now he just opened up his big eyes and he said, yes, yes. Something is going to happen and you want me to tell you that with what is going to happen in the forest. He was the wisest owl in the whole forest, and Hector knew that Oliver would know what was happening. This owl, Oliver Owl, he was the wisest owl in the forest, and Hector Hummingbird, he knew very well that owl must be knowing what is going to happen in the forest. It is simple, yawned Oliver. Now, Oliver was yawning and said, it is very simple. The king is coming to the forest for a picnic. Okay, now this Oliver said, the king is coming to the forest for a picnic. Now, budge off and let me sleep. He closed his big brown eyes. He just closed his eyes and he said, now you please go from here and let me sleep. The king, Hector had never seen the king. Now, Hector was very excited to see king because he never saw the king. He spent the rest of the morning sipping nectar from the forest flower, and then he heard the sound of voices. Okay, so that morning he was busy in sipping nectar from the forest flower, and suddenly he heard a sound. He fluttered through the trees until he came across the picnic. Now he was just moving flying through the trees and he just reached to the picnic spot. Wow, there was the king and the queen and even the little princess. Okay, when he went there, he saw that king was there, queen was there, and little princess was there. Now, all of you just turn your page, beta. Hector watched from a tree as the picnic continued, with footmen serving huge arrays of treats and tidbits. Now, Hector, he was sitting on a tree and he was watching to the royal family where servants were serving them with treats and with small small beads of food. Other servants flitted about making sure everything was perfect for the royal family, and other servants, they were just arranging everything very nicely so that they can see that everything is perfect or everything is very good for this royal family. Hector chuckled. Hector just smiled. He smiled. The servants were just like hummingbird, darting here and there everywhere. Okay, he just chuckled. Chuckled, it means smile. Okay, he smiled and said to himself that these servants are just like Hector hummingbird, because they are also moving here and there. They are also running here and there. Everybody was having a wonderful time until the queen looked up into the trees and screamed. Okay, now everything was going on perfectly. Everything was perfect. Everyone was having their, they were enjoying their party. But suddenly queen looked up into the trees and screamed. He just saw up on the tree and he just shouted loudly. My baby, she cried, my little girl. Okay, she cried, my baby, she, my little girl. Everybody looked up. Now everybody just looked up. While they had been so busy picnicking, the princess had climbed high up into a big old oak tree and was now on the branch far above the ground. As everybody was enjoying their party, so this little princess, she just climbed into a big old oak tree, and she was now on a branch far above from the ground. Save my daughter, commanded the king. The king commanded, he also shouted, save my daughter, please save my daughter. But just as his men ran towards the tree, the princess slipped. As these servants, okay, they just moved towards the tree, the prince slipped. Grabbing the branch with her hands, she dangled helplessly in the air. Now, she was grabbing the branch with her hand and she was just dangling helplessly in the air. She couldn't hold on very long and would surely fall, as she could not hold that branch for a long time and surely she is going to fall from the tree. Suddenly they heard the crowd. There, way up in the tree, was hummingbird pulling the princess by the dress back onto the branch. And hummingbird was there. He was trying to save this little princess. So he was holding or pulling her by the dress back onto the branch. Hector pulled and pulled, and his wings hummed and hummed, but the princess was too heavy. Just this hummingbird, he was trying to hold that little princess, but this little princess was quite heavy for this little hummingbird. He could feel her slipping as her grip on the branch failed. Now this Hector hummingbird could feel that now this girl is going to fall. Then a voice sounded in his ear. Then he heard a voice in his ear. He who is not strong enough must be smart enough. Okay. He heard a sentence in his ear that he who is not strong enough must be smart enough. Hector glanced around but could not see Oliver. Okay. Now this Hector hummingbird, he just saw around him but he did not find this Oliver. He did, however, see a strong vine hanging against the tree trunk. Okay, now he saw a vine hanging against the tree trunk. In the blink of an eye, Hector grabbed the end of the vine. Okay, suddenly this Hector, he just held the end of the vine, and as the prince fell, he flew with it around and around the princess, finally noting the vine under itself. As the princess fell, he just flew around and around the princess by knotting a vine under itself. Now, the hummingbird could have flown so fast. Now, he was able to fly so fast. Everybody gasped as the princess kept falling. Everybody was looking because this princess, she was just to fall. And then she was suddenly pulled up short. By this Hector hummingbird. The vine held. The princess dangled safely in the air. Now the princess was dangling safely in the air. Three of the king's men scrambled up the tree and soon had her safely on the ground again. She was unhurt. Then suddenly, three men of this king, they just climbed onto the tree and they just took the princess on the ground. The forest was filled with the cry, "Hooray for the hummingbird!" Now the forest was filled with the cry, and everybody was shouting, "Hooray for the hummingbird!" Because this little princess was saved by hummingbird. Hector moved into the castle at the king's insistence. Okay, now Hector was invited into the castle of king. The royal gardener planted special flower gardens full of his favorite blooms. Now the garden, okay, it was full of favorite flowers of this Hector hummingbird. He was great friends with the princess, and they often played together in the forest. So this Hector hummingbird and the princess, they become very good friend, and they started playing. They even used to play in the forest together. Although she was not allowed to climb any more trees, but this little princess, she was not allowed to climb any tree. The king gave a huge feast and all the guests stood and toasted Hector. Okay, now this king, he was very happy. So he gave a party, or he gave a huge feast, and all the guests, they were very happy. They were very happy and they just stood up and they wished Hector, who hummed with happiness. Then at that point the king declared that from now onwards you shall be known as Hector Hummingbird the Hero. Now the king declared that you shall be known as the Hector Hummingbird the Hero. So children, this was the explanation of the chapter 5, Hector Hummingbird. I hope you must have understood this chapter very well. So children, you all need to practice, or you all need to answer the question. Even you can do this true and false by yourself. So children, thank you so much for watching my video. Thank you so much.